I'm over in the corner of the Palais de Tokyo, under the Cinematheque, which when I first saw the space, I was immediately intrigued by it because it kind of evoked for me this idea of something beneath the cinema, a sort of subconscious or a sort of nervous system under the cinema space or under the cinema machine. So I think that was my starting point. Now, what I've constructed is in a way a bit like a body. It will probably to many people appear as a sort of grotto or a sort of labyrinthic space, but as an architecture it evokes a body. You enter from the bottom up, so to speak, and then you at some point you'll pass through three different spaces, four different spaces, and then you'll pass through the neck and end up what we have just for reference called the brain part. I guess the reptile part technically would be part of the brain. It refers to an older part of the brain, or like if we are kind of put it into a sort of altered state or sort of state of being, maybe a more instinctual state, or it's a part of the brain that we that is very old, and that kind of fascinates me. It fascinates me that our brains are not quite developed at the same time. So different, there's almost like different layers. There's an archaeology of the brain, and the reptile brain is definitely one of the oldest part. I think I have what what I call inhaling the show. And what I mean by the inhaling the show is taking the show in through the body. And the mode of approaching a group of works like this one and on the inhaling level would be just walking through. It's almost can be described as a walk, like a tour. You just walk through the spaces and you walk through in at one side and come out at another side. And just where that leaves you. And then there's the other part which has to do with the conceptual layer and all the narratives that are unfolded, narratives that maybe disappear and reappear in different forms. That's more like a mental or conceptual landscape, and that's maybe a layer you will approach more as a spectator if you spend more time with the work and you kind of carry it with you in a different way or think about it as you kind of walk through. So I think my idea of a setup or my idea of doing an installation where I display my work is derived from those two modes of seeing or encountering works. I think there's one work is in a way relevant to this, and this is this work called, or this film called, Of Spirits and Empty Spaces, which derives from this spiritist group in the United States who tried to develop a sewing machine through a trance dance. They went into trance and then they became the sewing machine. Each of the members would become a part of this imaginary sewing machine, and then they would, when they came out of trance, they would try to assemble the part to develop this new machine. So I think that is, maybe that is in a way related to art, in the sense it's kind of like finding different ways of production, finding different ways of approaching subject matter. I think that's very much what these ideas from maybe spirituality or the occult has been for me. It has been a way to kind of reshuffle ideas, to kind of to create a different space where things would appear a little different from what they normally do. So maybe there is a kind of a relationship between that ritual of creating that imaginary machine, which was very much done in order to find a way around big business, because at that time there were some very heavy patents controlling the sewing machines, and an industry that made it impossible for example, a single woman to buy a sewing machine and use that to make a living. So there was it had a kind of idealistic approach. There was socialist and maybe that, yeah, maybe that in some way relates to art production, which can be somehow idealistic, and also where the parameter maybe for success is not so much whether this machine actually worked. They did produce a sewing machine, but it was never very successfully distributed. And I think that is a parallel to art as well. It's kind of like, in a way, sometimes hard to say what makes a work successful and how it is kind of how it enters society and how it enters our way of interacting.